In today's video, we are going to be checking out how Kyle Lowry plays post defense, how he can defend two players at the exact same time, and how you can imitate Kyle Lowry and become a better post defender yourself, whether you are a center, a guard, or a forward. These are all skills that you're going to need to have, so let's get down and let's break down how Kyle Lowry plays post defense on the weak side. Okay, so what we have here is Kyle Lowry guarding a forward. And some players, or some people may call him a center, but I personally call him a forward. From here, what we have is, of course, Kyle Lowry getting nice and low. Really quickly, this is not that great of footage. The reason why this is not that great of footage is because I recorded it from my TV. Apparently, the Bell Box does not allow capture cards to record. So that kind of sucks. HDCP sucks. But anyways, he is getting super low. How is he getting super low and able to keep that big player away from the rim? Well, number one, Kyle Lowry has his foot between his feet, basically creating a chair. This is fantastic because it keeps you super low, especially if you have your foot, what a lot of coaches or trainers may call a negative step if you're trying to explode out of it. He's got a negative step to support him. From there, he's able to keep his arms bent. You do not want to have straight arms, it's a foul. Bent arms into the lower back makes that player not want to post you up because it can hurt slightly. But anyways, going from there, what we see is now a slight screen away. This player is going to be then cutting towards the point. Now at this point in time, what we have is a double team off of that screen. The reason is because Bradley Beal is a very good basketball player, and anytime that we can double team, or the Toronto Raptors could double team him, you are now creating an opportunity to get a turnover because he is their number one focus. Now, this puts Kyle Lowry in a very bad situation. Kyle Lowry is 6'1", 6'2", in that range, and he now has to guard multiple players who are close to 7 feet tall. So how Kyle Lowry is able to do this is he will defend the post. He's not worried about the player out on the three-point line at this point in time. The ball is over here. The skip pass over to this side is extremely hard to do. And because of that, he wants to protect the post, number one. This is a lot higher of a percentage shot when wide open than a three-point shot is when wide open. So this is basically 100%. This is like 60% when wide open with most players. So what he does is he stays in the post and he's able to protect that post until we get the center back to the low post. Once the center's able to get back, they call switch. This is very important. You really want to talk when you're on defense. Kyle Lowry at this point will say switch, switch, switch. That means that the center is now going to be able to say, okay, well, I'm going to be switching on to my guy because Kyle Lowry was originally guarding him. Kyle Lowry now is not playing Hachimura very closely. He is close enough to be able to contest a shot, but what's going to happen now is we have what looks to be Westbrook driving towards the rim. What's going to happen is our center is a very charge-happy center. He's going to try and take a charge potentially, or maybe block a shot on that. Kyle Lowry is now going to be sliding down because this player has moved into what we call up here, or old coaches call up here in Canada, the Russian spot. Right here to here is the Russian spot. This is where the Russians used to kill Team Canada back in, I think it was the 60s or something, way back, way, way long ago. And because of that, Kyle Lowry is able to dip down. We have that double team in the low post once again with what looks to be Westbrook, who drove. Kyle Lowry is able to slip down so that there's no pass to this player who can then go up to the rim and dunk it on Baines. So Kyle Lowry is able to cut off that pass down towards the baseline, still be close enough to contest a shot out to Hachimura. I cannot say that guy's name. But now we are still in our man-to-man defense, and he has now basically broken up a potential easy basket in the key. He has again broken up a quick easy pass to the baseline for an easy layup or dunk, and he's still contesting the ability for Hachimura to then shoot that ball. But because there's such a size difference between these two players, Hachimura is going to then try and post up Kyle Lowry, which is a mistake that every single tall player makes. And because of that, he is posting up Kyle Lowry, posting him up. Look at the angle that Kyle Lowry has. So basically, we have Hachimura who's facing that direction. Kyle Lowry's hand is up in that direction to contest the shot. At the same time, look at the angle his body is at. His body is super angled so that if Hachimura was to go and try and shoulder Kyle Lowry in the post, he has enough strength so that he could push back with his chest so that this player is unable to post him up. And that's what we were just seeing. Now at this time, Hachimura takes his two steps. Kyle Lowry's able to smack down on that ball. Now remember, when you are posting up a player, you want to keep that ball high. You do not want to bring it down towards your waist, to your stomach. In that area, what's going to happen is Kyle Lowry is going to strip him. And that's what happens. And that's the end of this play. But what we can take from this is to be low, to have an angle to be able to absorb the hit, to be able to give back a slight hit with your chest. And then if a player makes a mistake, see, he brought it up high, that's good, but he brought it back down low. You want to keep it up high, and Kyle Lowry is able to see that. He's able to smack down, no foul because he got all ball, and then now we're able to go back the other direction onto offense. This is fantastic post defense by the one and only Kyle Lowry. Now, if you are a guard who is smaller like Kyle Lowry but beefy like Kyle Lowry, this is a fantastic way to play post defense. Even I can play post defense like this. Even if you are slightly underweight as a guard, you can still play post defense like this. You just need to have the angle. You need to have the angle on your body to be able to absorb a hit and to be able to give back a slight hit with your chest. When they're coming towards you, you can stick your chest out, flex your chest, protect yourself, and you're able to now give back that hit. You're able to absorb that energy, and then it's basically given back, like if that person is running into a wall. And if he hits you hard enough, then you fall, and then it's a charge. But at the same time, I hope that this video has helped you become a better defensive player. If it has, hit that like button, subscribe. I'll see you guys again next time.